I'd just like to poll this audience real quick. Raise your hand if you like public speaking. Okay, that looks like a minority. Raise your hand if you dislike public speaking. Okay, that's actually pretty evenly split. I think some people didn't vote. If you didn't, shame on you. We've got some incentives for you folks who dislike public speaking. So tonight, I'm very excited to tell you that we are doing a real estate investing spooky story competition. So the mic will be open if you're interested in presenting a horror story that you have experienced during your real estate investing career. And to sweeten the prize and incentive people who dislike public speaking, we've got rewards for the best speakers tonight. First place, we'll get a $100 gift card. Second and third place, we'll get a $50 gift card. The way that we'll be voting is we have this this polling software that I'll be punching in on my computer. We're going to add everyone who speaks to the drawing. And then all of the people here at the meeting tonight will vote with a QR code who you think presented the best spooky story. So go ahead and start thinking right now, you know, maybe what story could I present? I'll be happy to present the first story tonight. Since I'm a board member, I won't, you know, add myself to the drawing. But I'll present a story just to get us started. And then I'll ask who wants to speak next. You can just raise your hand, come on up, and again, first place wins $100 gift card, second and third place, $50 gift card. Okay, my real estate investing horror story. So for those of you who know me, I own a property management company called Blue Door Living. I started my company 4 years ago. We were managing 40 units. We now manage about 525, employ about 19 people. Very grateful for our success and our growth. when we first started, there was one employee, and that was me, and I wasn't getting paid very much. As the only employee of the company, I had a tremendous amount of responsibility, collecting rent, paying all the bills, sometimes handling maintenance calls, even though I'm not very handy. And we were managing a 6-unit on Douglas Street. Raise your hand if you're familiar with Douglas Street on the west side. Okay, some people. Douglas Street, so the west side I think is known for being a little bit nicer than the east side. You know, generally speaking, we got some dissenters here. But yeah, parts. I think Douglas Street is maybe one of those parts that's not nicer. And so we were managing the 6-unit, and we had some challenges with it, right? We had, you know, late rent payments, you know, rougher tenants. And we had this one tenant in the 6-unit, single woman. She fell behind on her rent. I felt quite bad for her, actually. You know, she lost her job. Things were just sort of, you know, going poorly for her. We started an eviction against her, tried to work with her. She sort of fell out of contact. I hadn't heard from her for about 2 months. The hearing had already passed. The writ of possession was going to be issued. And she texts me and she says, "Hey, I'm out." And I thought, okay, great. Well, we'll withdraw the writ of possession. I'll come change the locks. You know, I'll be in touch about your security deposit, all that. I go to the property. And I go to enter her unit, and the door's locked. I thought, that's weird. And then I listened a little closer, and I heard voices. And I thought, that's weird. And I knock on the door, and this humongous man answers the door. This guy was like 6'5", tattoos, and he's like, "What's up?" And I'm like, "You're not Jessica." And he's like, "Nope, I'm Jessica's friend. She said I could stay here. I've been paying her rent." I said, "Really? Okay. Well, I don't have a lease with you. I have a lease with Jessica, and that lease just terminated. So I'd like you to leave, please." And he said, "F you," and slammed the door in my face. So I was dealing with a squatter situation. First time ever, and surprisingly, it happened very early in my property management career. So I decided to call the police. You know, I got people in these units. I don't know them. You know, they aren't authorized to be here. And so I call the police, and the Manchester police show up. And I, you know, tell them what's going on. And, you know, they say, "This is probably going to be more complicated than just removing them." I said, okay. They went to the unit. I decided to also enter the unit. And that ended up being a good move, because I think if I didn't enter the unit, I probably wouldn't have gotten repossession of that unit. And they talked with this guy. It turns out that he had a warrant. You know, he got arrested. The other person just kind of jumped out the window or something. And it looked like the apartment was empty. Great. The police left. I asked them if they could stay. They left. So I start changing the locks. And I hear some rustling. I'm like, what the hell is that? I go in. There was another person hiding in the closet. All right. Thankfully, it was a woman. And you know, I'm not some giant dude that's going to beat the crap out of me. And
so you could take her?
Yeah, I could definitely fight her. No problem. Thankfully, I didn't fight her. But I said, hi, you know, this is my unit now. Could you please leave? No, screw you. Okay, call the police. Please come back. They remove this woman. They leave again immediately. And I start changing the locks. I changed the inside door, and then it had a back porch door. And I'm starting to change the lock, and you know, they're like waiting out by the street. Mm. And I'm like, oh my goodness, like when I get done changing the lock, I have to walk past them to get my car. I certainly don't want to do that. So I just go in the unit, lock myself in there, pull up some YouTube and watch about 2 hours of YouTube videos. Come back out, they're gone, we're good to go, change the lock, went home. It all ended up being okay. But that was very scary. I thought I was going to get beaten up once or twice. And I learned a little bit about, you know, some squatting law. And I was glad to get repossession of that unit. But that was probably the scariest moment in property management, was when I was in that unit and I heard some rustling. I thought, like, man, I'm about to have an altercation with someone. This is really scary. And evictions in general, too, are sort of some of the scariest points in property management. So that's my horror story. Thanks for listening.